How's it going, YouTube? Welcome back to your favorite aviation channel, and today I'm finally bringing to you all a new airport update for Lahore Allama Iqbal International Airport. It's been almost 4 months since the last update for Lahore, and the reason why it's been so long is quite honestly because I've just not had motivation to do these updates. I felt like they were getting kind of repetitive, but today I felt that because I'm on Thanksgiving break for the next few days, and also because it's been such a long time, I don't have any excuse not to do a Lahore update. So here we are. This is the 11th update, based at 3 a.m. So most of the aircraft you see in this video are going to be pretty familiar to you all. Thank you to everybody who's been super patient with me in the making of this video. A lot of people have been asking when's the next Lahore update coming out. And I kept saying I'm not too sure. I'm working on it. But this video is for everybody who's, you know, kept their patience with me. I appreciate that. So let's get started with the video. Hopefully it doesn't take too long. Shouldn't take too long as far as I know. But before we get into the actual aircraft, here's a brief overview of the airport. It's been a while. Airport's been in the same spot it's always been. I haven't removed it. I haven't, you know, taken it down. It's been sitting like this, you know, ever since the last time you saw it. As you can see, I have the airport lights on, as well as the basement lights on, the surrounding lights. I've never done this before, this kind of setup. In the previous few updates, it's been just the airport lights on, and the basement lights have been off to give it that proper nighttime effect. But this time, I decided why not turn the basement lights on, make things a bit different. Doesn't make a whole lot of sense because this is a nighttime update, but, you know, it is what it is. I mean, technically, I'm filming this at, what, 10 p.m.? 10:30? 10:30, yeah. So, I mean, I'm filming it at nighttime, so that kind of counts, I guess. But anyway, yeah, 5 planes in this update, that's it. So hopefully it doesn't take too long. I don't want to waste too much of your time because you probably have better things to do than watch a model airport update. But that's depending on how you live your life. I don't know, I'm not one to judge. But let's get started with the video with the aircraft. First plane here pushing back from gate 4 is this PIA Pakistan International Airbus A320-200. And it's going off to Sharjah in the UAE as flight 185. As far as Pakistani aviation goes, it's growing very rapidly. AirBlue recently just got 2 new Airbus A321neos. These are the newest of the new. These are the newest aircraft in the Airbus lineup, I guess you could say. And AirBlue is the first and only Pakistani airline currently operating the A320neo family. So these are the newest planes in Pakistan, brand new, and AirBlue is going to do great things with them, I'm sure. Serene Air, they got 2 new A330s. They have 3 total now, but I think they got 2 more in the previous past few months. So they have 3 total along with the 4 737s. So Serene Air, again, they're doing pretty good now that they've started an international service. And then there's AirSial. AirSial is the same old because they just recently started operations back in December 2020. They're still a brand new airline. They have not expanded their fleet yet because they only have, you know, they still have their 3 Airbus A320s, and yeah, they've been doing pretty good for now. They haven't even completed a year of operations. They're almost about to do it. December 25th will mark their first full year of operation, but so far they're doing pretty good. And then there's the national flag carrier PIA. They're doing all right as well. They recently just got 2 A320s, I think, or they've gotten 1 so far, but they have 1 more on the way. They're both former Interjet aircraft, so they used to fly with Interjet in Mexico. Interjet went bankrupt last year, I think, so PIA was able to snag 2 former Interjet A320s. They have sharklets on them, which is pretty cool. That makes the aircraft more fuel efficient. So they're fairly new. They're like 6 years old, I think. The funny thing is, PIA never repainted them, so let me show you what I'm talking about. Here's the aircraft right here. This is one of them, APBOK. How old is it? 6 years? Oh, 4 years, okay. So, you can see it's still in Interjet livery. They never repainted it. Like, this is how it looks like right now. PIA bought, like, they got the airplane like this, and they never bothered to repaint it. It still operates in Interjet livery. It has the Pakistan registration right there, as you can see, APBOK, but there's no PIA branding whatsoever on this, and that's not really a good thing considering, you know, Interjet doesn't exist anymore. They went out of business last year, and number two is a Mexican airline, Interjet's not a Pakistani airline, or they were a Mexican airline, not that that matters, but there should at least be some sort of PIA branding on this, but there isn't, and I don't know why PIA is letting this slide, because if I was flying PIA, I would expect to fly a PIA-branded plane, not Interjet. So this is how the plane looks like right now. That's how it's flying. I don't know when they're going to repaint it, but they should definitely repaint it soon, because it's not really a good sort of look for them, as far as I'm concerned. But yeah, and then PIA's long-haul fleet, you know, 777s, a good amount of them are grounded still, but then a few of them are also still flying, which is good, but, you know, what can you do? All right, moving on to the next four planes, all internationals. Right here we have the Virgin Atlantic 787-9, which is about 90 minutes late today for whatever reason. Flight 365 back to London Heathrow, and is getting cargo on and catering and all that before it returns back to Heathrow. Scheduled departure time 3:25 a.m., but it is late, so it probably won't end up leaving until like 4:30. So there we go. And Virgin Atlantic and British Airways, they've been doing pretty good as far as I'm concerned on London and, Islamabad and Lahore. So that's good to see. And then, oh yeah, back about PIA. Apparently they've been cleared, their safety record in the European Union. Apparently they've been cleared. The European safety audit, I guess they passed it. So apparently they're safe enough to start flying their own planes back to Europe and the UK. I hope they do that soon, because they really, really depended on those European flights, especially the UK ones, big money makers for them. A lot of Pakistanis live in Europe and especially the UK. So hopefully soon they can get their European UK routes started up again with their own planes and start making some money on them flights, because they need it. But they haven't really specified when and if they're going to restart those flights, because right now they're operating like some sort of leased A330 to London or something. I'm not too sure what they're doing right now, but yeah, that's the situation right now. Next up, I think this is the first time I've ever shown this on the channel. This is the Kuwait Airways 777-300ER. Just landed from Kuwait City as flight 203. And so I bought this model a while ago. I've had it for a long time. I've had it for a few months at least. I bought it specifically for Lahore because Kuwait flies to Lahore, duh. They don't fly to Karachi as far as I know. And of course they don't fly to Chicago. But they do fly their 777-300ERs to Lahore regularly. And so I bought it for this airport. Pretty nice model. This one is the 9K AOD. And this model has the 65th anniversary of Kuwait Airways stickers on it. Unfortunately, this livery doesn't exist anymore. The stickers, at least, they've been removed, because this is a 2019 release. That's when the model was made, back in 2019. And back then, Kuwait Airways were celebrating their 65th anniversary. Now, of course, it's 2021, and they don't need these stickers anymore. So this like special sticker here and the 65th anniversary sticker on the front, they have removed those. So I guess I might have to try my best to remove these as well if I can. But yeah, pretty good model though. I like the Kuwait Airways new livery. I mean, it's not that new anymore. It came out in like 2017, but yeah, it's a nice livery. I like it a lot. And this is the first time, like I said, I've shown this on the channel, which is weird. I've had it for such a long time, but I've never had the opportunity to showcase it in a video. But there you go. And next up is the Qatar Airways 777-300ER, and is getting ready to head back out to Doha. Getting ready for pushback as flight 621? Let me just double check. I think it's 621. Yeah, 621 back to Doha. Qatar Airways 333 in the One World livery. And strangely enough, I mean, Qatar Airways used to fly like almost their entire fleet to Pakistan, like, you know, A350. A320, 321, 330, 787, 777. Now it's almost exclusively 777-300ER to Islamabad, Karachi, and Lahore. Very occasionally they might sub in an A350 or a 777-200LR, but for the most part, Lahore, Islamabad, Karachi, they all get these 333s. Peshawar gets the 787 nowadays, which is good for them. I think Sialkot is a mix of 787, A320, 777, and then the smaller major cities like Faisalabad and Multan, I think they still get like A320s and stuff, but yeah, good stuff. And then last aircraft is the Turkish A330-300,
Pulling into gate 9 from Istanbul, that's flight 714. And I think Turkish is a mix of A330-300 and 777-300ER to Islamabad, Karachi, Lahore. So, yeah, good stuff there. And that concludes the airport update. Took me like, I kid you not, this literally took me like six, seven tries to get this video filmed. And that's nothing new. It always takes me that long to make these videos. Hope you enjoyed the video, though. If you did, please support the video with a like and subscribe if you're new here. And if you got any feedback or suggestions, you know, comment. That's always helpful. Thank you very much for watching. And hopefully you'll be able to make more videos. I don't know what else to say. But, yeah, thank you guys a lot for tuning in to the end. Hope you guys enjoyed it. And I will see you in the next one. All right? Take care and goodbye.